Welcome back to my channel, and if you're new, hey, what's up? My name is Tanya, and thank you all so much for joining in and watching this video. This video is going to be a tutorial on how to achieve this eye look right here. It is so glam, bold, glittery, sparkly, gold, like just the glitter, the gold, the orange, the pink, the boldness. It is over the top, but it's my birthday today, so I thought it was a perfect occasion to go full on glam. I walk you through step by step how to achieve the whole eye look, what lashes I'm wearing, how to get this color combination on the lips, what I'm doing for a highlight, blush combination. So every step is covered as far as what products are used, but you actually get it step by step on the eyes. And I'm so happy with the way it turned out. I used glitter injections for the glitter on my eyes and then the Masquerade palette to get all of that nice burnt orangey colors and every other thing that's going on. And then Jeffree Star for my Beaten Highlight, of course. But I tell you everything in detail if you keep on watching. But I don't know, with glitter injections, you'll see in a minute, that's what we get into first, is how unimpressed I am by their customer service, because I got initiated with them back in October, and then the dispute started in November because I had damaged products, and then they were supposed to send me new ones, said they were going to, had a couple back and forths, they kept telling me they were sending them. We're now on January 23rd and I still haven't received them, so I'm not getting them. And then they also say that you don't need glitter glue. I think that is a total lie. I then swatch all these shades for you and there is no way that without glitter glue these would not be patchy and that you would be able to build to the intensity that you would like and that you wouldn't have fallout. Now I am so happy with the look I created and how it all came together, but I used glitter glue everywhere there is glitter. So I think if I hadn't done that, this would have been a hot mess. I did try it out on the lips and it did work out really well on the lips. That's not what's on my lips right now. I used something else because I'm going to eat and that glitter would go everywhere on your face once you start eating. So their claims about the glitter glue and the glitter all being meshed into these pans, I think are false, totally false, because every single shade you would need glitter glue for. But I mean, despite it being a complete disastrous mess, I did get a beautiful end result. It's just that to me, there's nothing really that much more special about this compared to other glitters. Like, I think I could achieve the same glitter effect using lip glitters. You know, these come pre-mixed with different tones. So like I used one that had a purpley pink shade mixed with an orangey shade. So I wanted to do my upper top with like orangey shades and then do a cut crease and then glitter. So, I mean, it was just pre-done for me. I didn't have to mix some of my lip glitters, but I mean, it was just everywhere. When I swatched it, I took like 3 makeup wipes to get it off and there was still glitter everywhere. Then I had glitter particles. Like, it was just, I'm not going to be reaching for this. I mean, I want to give it a couple more chances, but it was just, the concept is really great. Having like pressed glitters in single pans, they have so many varieties of all these different mixtures, huge ones that you can buy. Like, the concept that they have is so great, but they have a lot of work to do on developing it. And I hope that they do, and I hope that they really improve their customer service. As I show you, all of their links are dead. You can't even contact them. I had to do Google searches and all of these things to try to find even an email to reach out to them that I received for majorly damaged products. A fifth one was like a little bit damaged out of 10. And everything's dead except for the glitter to add to cart and checkout. So, and then it was also misleading because they said it was like a 10 Z palette limited edition collection or something, and it didn't come with a Z palette, but the way it was worded, they led you to believe that you were getting them in a Z palette, and you didn't. You got them in little individual, like you get individual eyeshadows. So I have really mixed feelings about this company because I feel like they have a really genius idea and they are on the right track. They just have not perfected it and they have a lot of work to do in the formulation department and they need to get on improving this product. But it's still really good. It's just not worth the hassle when you have so many other options. But if you guys want to stay tuned for swatches, how to create this eye look, see it in action and how it all works out and everything, then just keep on watching. All right, I don't even know how to start this part with the glitter injections. I mean, I guess up close, you guys can see this is so glittery. It's actually gonna be hard to tell. I'll pull it out. The chunks of glitter that came missing. Look at that. Do you see that gap? I know it's hard to tell, but there's a huge hole right there. These look like they're gonna be an awesome product to work with, but four came that damaged. Look at this orange. I haven't used these yet. I've been waiting. Like, that is a huge gap again, just chunk taken out. And these are expensive. These are something like at least $10 a pop. And look at that chunk too. So when you get the packaging, the problem is the packaging. Look at how much was left over on that packaging. Like, look at that chunk of glitter. Is that not terrible? So it comes sitting on this magnet, folded over, and just smushed. And I was so careful when I opened it, as you can see. And when I opened it, it was still on here, but that much of a chunk was off of it. So as you can imagine, knowing me and glitter, I was beyond excited for this package to arrive. And I so randomly came across them because they were like a sponsored ad in my Instagram feed. Go figure that, you know, glitter companies are companies that are advertising that get filtered through into my feed. So when I went on their website, they have, like, these are normal size pans, but they have pans that are like this big of glitter. They have loose glitter, they have so many glitters, but this bundle was like a limited edition release that was a pre-order. So I have all the emails open, did my pre-order for this package October 26th. So it was a limited edition of 10 and it came up to $117 for those 10. And four came gouged. So they arrived on November 5th, and at that same day that they arrived, I immediately emailed the company, which they do not want to be emailed. Every link on their site is a dead link, except the glitter links to add to cart and then checkout. everything else is dead, and I'm going to show you that. But you wouldn't be looking for all of that other information. You're just looking at the product and how beautiful it looks, and it just draws you in because of the beauty. So I didn't know that they are like hiding themselves from being found to have any kind of problem resolution. So after digging and digging and then typing in searches on the internet, I finally found an email address. So I thought, well, I'm gonna try this one and see if it works. And it was a Saturday, so I didn't expect a response over the weekend, and I didn't get one, but I got one on Monday, which was a nice surprise. So I emailed all the pictures of the colors and the big chunks that were missing, showing them up close images, how the packaging arrived, and just how damaged my products were. And I was really pleasant. I just said, you know, as you can imagine, I was beyond excited to receive my glitters, but a bunch of them arrived very broken. So much of the glitter was broken out of the pans and stuck onto the packaging. I'm very disappointed in how they arrived and that I've attached photos, and I'm not sure what your policy is because I can't find anything on your website. And the girl wrote back saying, what is your order number? I'll resend them today. First of all, I put the order number in my subject of the first email, order number. And then I gave that oversight, that's fine. So I gave her the order number, and then she said that maybe we need to add more bubble wrap, or can you please open them more carefully? I'm like, I open them as carefully as, like, you can imagine me. Like, I'm holding these glitters and I'm cutting it open. Like, I'm so anal. I tell her, like, if anyone is opening up packages carefully, it's me when it's glitter. And so we go back and forth quite a few times over a couple of days. And she's saying, she keeps telling me, I'll send these four tomorrow. And by mid-November, I just gave up because she never sent them. I never received them. And now it is January 24th. And the ordeal started on November 5th, but my order was placed October 26th. But then when you go to their website, it is so, like, awesome. I mean, the products that they have are amazing, and they draw you in. And when you're looking at some of these glitters, oh my gosh, like, it just is, that not like the most beautiful glitter? And you don't have to add glitter glue. The glitter glue is supposedly like built in, so you just take your finger and you just start dabbing and working the amount that you want. They come out with these massive pans that have all those shades, so you can like just take a little bit of one shade. Same with like all of these ones. Those are like triangled off. Like, these just look like I wanted to buy every shade, and they have pages and pages. Yet when you get down here, it says company, about, glitter injections, menu, support, contact, frequently asked questions, terms of use. You put your mouse over it, every single one is a dead link. Even contact. There's nothing you can do. Support, nothing you can do. Oops, look. So nothing, contact, support. I've never seen a worse company. It is so unacceptable and so ridiculous. So we are going to get to swatching and seeing how these actually work once they're swatched, and then put them to the test in a tutorial. But I wanted to show you guys that before we even get into it, if it does turn out to be amazing, order at your own risk, because it is very pricey. And out of 10, 4 arrived very damaged, 1 arrived cracked. That's like 50% of the order though, but 40% being like a good chunk destroyed. So just order at your own risk if it is nice, but I don't even know. I've literally held on to this since November 6th, but we're going to get to it and see how they are. And so now that you've seen that and how broken I don't know. So I'm going to start swatching and then we will go from there. So I started with this row and I got all of them on me in order, but this was a limited edition release. So if you love these colors, you can find very similar colors on their website. So this is the first one and it looks blinding, but it actually swatched really chunky. This one is kind of patchy. This one, the monitor is not showing. It is so patchy. Like, you can see my skin through this one. Maybe there on that angle you can see it. That one did not swatch well at all. This one was kind of like, eh. Like, the colors are beautiful. But this one was really patchy. You can kind of see the skin. Same with this pink one. The burgundy. And then there are the other two. So I am definitely... like, you can even see fallout happening already. And it says that there is no fallout, no glitter glue needed because it's built in there. But I don't buy it. So I'm still gonna put these to the test for you guys and try to create a really fun, sparkly look and hope that this works, because today is actually my birthday. It is the 23rd that I'm filming it, so I really want like a super glitter lid, and I should probably just be going with Lit Cosmetics because they are tried and true, but it is a very intimate dinner, so if all else fails, whatever. I put this to the test for you guys, so, and this makes me happy doing that. I'm kind of disappointed in how these swatched out, even though they are really banging colors. I'm definitely going to use glitter glue. Like, there's no way I'm not putting glitter glue because the fallout already. And then when I like touched this, it just like moves around and smushes. But you, like, it looks pigmented, but it really, it's like soft. It's not very tacky. It just, I don't know how to explain it. I can't see this holding up without glitter glue and not becoming a total disaster. Cleaning that glitter, there's still glitter. I went through 3 makeup wipes and there's still glitter. I've never swatched like glitter before because I've never had like glitter pans. It's always just individual glitter. That was a nightmare. Guys, I'm never doing the full face glitter challenge because that will just get into the pores and like exfoliate poorly, clog them. It will be awful. You have no idea what it took and there's still glitter. I'm sure this is gonna last for days. That is awful. I'm totally up for like the full face highlighter challenge. Not up for the glitter full face glitter challenge. Holy crap. But I'm going to prep and prime my eyelids, set them with powder, tight line, and then I'll zoom you guys in so we can get going on some kind of look and hope it doesn't turn out into a complete disaster. All right, I'm actually thinking of doing a cut crease. So using the Nubian palette, but using all of the warmer tones and that orange Cairo, I want to get in there, and using those above for the cut crease on the top, and then doing a full glitter lid on the bottom. So that's kind of my vision. I got lipstick on my teeth. My eyes are running like crazy again. This is unbelievable. And it makes me, it's so redundant. I'm so frustrated because it really does mess with the makeup game. So I'm gonna start my first transition shade with Burkina and my Carity E31 that I just ordered 2 more of because it's that good and I need some on backup. This is just so effortless. This brush is the perfect amount of fluff. My dogs are barking because a different company that I just discovered the package just arrived at the door. But this brush is the perfect amount of density and versus fluffiness, and it just gets the product on there so nicely and helps it blend and buff. This Carity brush is seriously perfection. I'm gonna bring it higher too because we are gonna do a dramatic look and having the cut crease with all the colors. Now I'm gonna take Ada. It's kind of an orangey. Even though it looks brown, it's definitely more of an orange-based brown. So I'm gonna do the same thing. Start building in that orange tone. These eyeshadows are just so good. Now I want to take Cairo, the glittery orange, but Fix Plus this one, and see how that guy performs. Not that you can really see the orange. Yeah, way you can see it. Well, the glitter doesn't really translate. Just beautiful color. It definitely does with a finger swatch, so this one might just be better, you know, having it on the lid using a finger or not a fluffy brush. Let me see. Even though we're gonna clean that up. Yeah. Now we're gonna cut the crease, and we definitely need to after I played with that eyeshadow on the one eye. So taking my MAC Pro Longwear Concealer, and it pumps some on the back of my hand. And then my trusty Sigma Cut Crease E62 that I should totally have memorized by now. We're gonna start cutting it. Now this is so getting intensified, but for now I'm gonna take Dahia, this shade, and put that under my brow bones, just to see how that looks. Oh, that is really pretty. I may not need too much intensifying. I just wanted to see some gold in there. Now normally I would dry off the concealer with a powder, but I want as much tackiness as possible. So I am going to go right into it with my glitter glue that for some reason just spit like water out at me. So let me give it a shake and see if the glitter glue can just mesh right into the concealer for the cut crease. And then get to the glitter, which will hopefully be the fun part and not the sad part. Let's go for fun. It's gonna be fun, people. It's gonna be fun, Fonz. I'm gonna take a little Morphe M124 for the parts that my big ass nails can't get to. And to make sure we don't wreck that nice cut crease line. And I'm gonna take this shade. They have no markings on them, but it is the one that's pink and has some, it's purpley pinkish with orange in there. Nope. These are just too crazy. Like, it's just so soft. It feels like I'm just rubbing glitter. Yeah, that glitter glue is gonna make a big difference. Definitely. And I already got glitter where I didn't want it up there. This is messy. It is not a like quick and easy glitter the way they claim it is at all. But it is definitely gleaming and beautiful. Yeah, look how easy that just wiped off. They are full of it when they say there's no glitter glue needed. But I'll give it to them on the shine. Like, that is beautiful. Just horrible customer service. And you can get this kind of beauty out of lit glitter. And you're not saving any steps because you really do need that glitter glue. Just so unique because all the colors are mixed together and then those big pans, like, they just need to improve their product. Like, they're on the right track. They got something going on. They just need to fix their shit. More glitter glue. It's getting chunky and patchy. Come on. I wonder how Wing is going to do over this. Anybody else feel like I'm pulling out an inner drag queen for the evening? See, these are supposed to be great for your lip glitter glue. Like, these were also, or your lip glitter oh my god. Glitter lips. When you do glitter lips, they claim that these are supposed to be the easiest, most effective way to go about doing them. So, I mean, let's test it out before my face is done. Well, it's there. You can really feel the glitter though. Like, uncomfortably feel the glitter. I wonder what kind of staying power this would have. You can definitely get. It tastes awful. A full coverage letter lip out of it though. So let's see if that transfers while we finish up doing more work with the eyes. I need another wipe. All right, it is time to line. I don't think I'm gonna do a wing. This is so weird. And the glitter keeps transferring to the teeth. So that's not cute. But I am gonna at least do the top lash line. Wow, go Tom Ford. He glided over that coarseness. Yeah, I don't like how the glitter goes all over the teeth. That's not cool. I popped out my falsies in Colored Rain number 013. Well, CR013, but really it's just number 13. And the glitter on my lips is actually still holding up, but it keeps transferring to my teeth and it's kind of starting to bleed out a little bit over here. So I think I should take it off before I put my foundation on. I think that's going to be a disaster. And then maybe try reapplying it for a couple cute, fun pictures with glitter lips afterwards. And then I'm just going to have glitter everywhere on my face. But I mean, it is really pretty. Like, look at how glittery that is and how light catching and everything. Like, on the eyes, it is so cool. And it really was an easy glitter lip. This is just the messiest glitter I've ever worked with. But it is, like, so pretty. Like, look at that. It's reflective. Why does it have to be so pretty, but such a disaster and such poor packaging and customer service? So I think I'm gonna wipe off my lip, go finish up my face, and then I'll be back to do the lower lash line. So I finished up my face and I used a combination of products. I used that Cerat blush that I have been loving to get a little extra color. But then I wanted to bring in some peachy tones, so I also mixed in Milani's Baked Blush in Luminoso. Oh, that packaging on that Cerat, let me tell you. So then I mixed in that one as well. And then I highlighted using I Had to Go Gold and Gleaming. It is my birthday today. King Tut, so I went bold. And then to get the color combination on my lips right now, because I thought this might be more comfortable than like doing a glitter lip. And I think the glitter lip, especially once I start eating, glitter is gonna go everywhere and it's just gonna be a disaster. Because I'm actually going out for dinner. I'm not just filming a tutorial and washing my face. So I used a combination of three things to achieve this look. My main color underneath is this Dose of Colors in Pinky Promise. And then I put a little bit of Jouer in their lip cream Daiquiri just to bring in a slight orange tone. But then to get this like crazy glittery, like I don't even know, iridescent reflective lip, I use Lime Crime Diamond Crushers in Lit. And these smell so good. They smell like candy. They're so yummy. But I'm really happy with how this is turning out because even though I'm always winging looks for you guys, today was a little bit of a gamble because I was winging a new look, playing with new products, playing with new glitter products, and doing something really bold and drastic, but I'm happy that I did it because I'm loving the way it is turning out. So I'm gonna zoom you guys in so we can finish up the lower lash line and get this makeup look complete. So starting with Burkina, the first transition shade that we used, I'm gonna take a small Morphe M507 brush and just smoke that along the lower lash line. Every time I use this palette, I forget how pigmented it is. I'm And I'm going to go over it with that Ada shade, our second shade that is like an orangey brown. Now we're going to go over it with Cairo. I'm going to try taking Bori with a smudger brush and see if I can bring some of that pink down below, because I don't want to mess with that glitter. I think that'll go all over my face. But we need to tie in a little bit of pink somehow. Yeah, it's not working the way I was hoping. I might have to grab a liquid liner. Glitter liquid liner. I'm going to take NYX Liquid Crystal Liner in 104 Crystal Silk, because that has some gold tones in it. Go over the pink with that. Now we need to highlight the inner corners using Jeffree Star's King Tut. All right, this crazy glam, glittery, sparkly, everything that I love that's so girly and over the top, just like glam, highlight, gleaming, glowing, just is done. So I'm gonna go get dressed and I will be back for my final look. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. I really hope that you love this look as much as I do. I'm so happy with this being my birthday look, because it is pink and sparkly and gold and highlighted and just glam and over the top, and it's like everything that I'm all about in the makeup world. So I'm so excited that this vision came together the way that it did, and that it didn't turn out to be a complete disaster with this glitter injection company, because it could have derailed really quickly. But instead, I am super happy with how it turned out. So I hope that you guys are too. You can tell I'm excited. I know. I'm like, I don't even know why. It's my birthday. I should get like a little break. It's my birthday. So I'm heading out for dinner now. My parents are in town, so that is awesome. And yeah, lipstick on my teeth, go figure. Oh, and my parents are calling right now. Hold on. So now my hubby's talking to my parents, so there could be some background noise because my dad called for like instructions. So anyway, that does it for this video. Please leave your comments, your feedback, your requests, anything below. And if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Please share it. Please subscribe if you haven't already. I hope everybody has an amazing week. And until next time, good night, good morning, wherever you are. I love you guys, and I will talk to you later. Bye.